If there ever were rival diets, keto, paleo, and Atkins would be the rivals. In today's video, I'm gonna break down exactly what each of these diets are, but I'm also gonna cover the major differences so that you can see for yourself which one is a bit more superior when it comes down to fat loss, but also when it comes down to improving your health too. But first, if you didn't catch yesterday's video, you're gonna wanna go back and check that out, because yesterday I released an announcement video letting everyone know that I just wrapped up the research and development for my all new carb detox diet known as KETOX. And to celebrate, I'm taking over the channel and giving you guys some of the all time best keto related content and recipes. Plus, for those of you who are interested in enrolling early into my KETOX course, I posted a link to my site so you can opt in for a chance to be one of 100 lucky subscribers that are gonna get my entire KETOX course absolutely free. But it actually gets better. When you opt in, I'm gonna give you my keto pizza cookbook so you can experience just how incredibly gratifying keto truly is. So just go ahead and click on the link to grab your free copy of my keto pizza cookbook. All right, so now let's actually talk some keto. So first off, what exactly is the ketogenic diet? So people first look at the ketogenic diet and they think that it's just abstaining from carbohydrates. They think that that's all it is. You're just getting rid of carbohydrates and it's a very limiting diet. Well, it's actually quite the opposite. Ketosis is sort of this euphoric, almost amazing system that your body goes into when you are deprived of carbohydrates, but when you're providing your body with really tasty fats. You see, your body has a unique way of taking those fats and converting them into something known as ketones. So when we're looking at the ketogenic diet or the keto diet, it's called that because your body produces ketones. So I don't want you to look at the keto diet as fat. I want you to look at the keto diet as utilizing ketones, which are very, very amazing when it comes down to giving your body energy. So when you do deprive your body of carbohydrates and increase your fat intake, it causes you to go into this state of ketosis, which is the source of the most rapid fat loss and so many other health benefits that you could ever imagine. Keto is super different from the Atkins diet, and it's a heck of a lot different from the paleo diet. The keto diet is based on keeping the fats elevated so that you produce ketones. The Atkins diet is all about getting rid of carbohydrates and not focusing so much on the fats. In my opinion, the Atkins diet focused on the negative. The ketogenic diet focuses on the positive. So then let's talk about the paleo diet for a second. See, the paleo diet, unfortunately, applies a lot of the principles to the ketogenic diet: higher fat, moderate protein, but it also has a small amount of carbohydrates into the mix. You see, what's interesting is that the ketogenic diet, to some degree, is pretty black and white. You have to get rid of carbohydrates in order for your body to ever utilize those ketones properly, in order for it to actually take fat and use it for fuel. Now, with the paleo diet, you have some carbs in the mix. So people often think that paleo is better than keto because you get the best of both worlds. But the hard part is you're having just enough carbohydrates to prevent you from ever truly getting into that magical ketogenic state. So it's like you get all the negative effects of reducing carbohydrates. Basically, you're running low on energy, you're running low on sleep, you're running low on all these things, you feel cruddy, but you're never able to actually produce ketones. You're just getting the effects of a low carb diet. So that's where a big difference between low carb and keto comes in. If your carbs are low enough, then your body has the ability to produce those ketones. And I promise you that the ketones are gonna allow you to feel so much better than you ever felt on carbohydrates. So people get all freaked out and they think that when they reduce their carbs, that they're gonna have all this sleepiness and they're gonna feel cruddy and they're gonna feel really weak and lethargic. And that is the case if you don't have the fats in the mix and if your carbs aren't low enough. So all you do is you substitute your carbs with really good tasting fats. We're talking about literally things like chocolate, almond butter, some peanut butter, all these things that taste really good and they give you very, very superior energy, especially compared to the energy you would get when you're on a paleo style diet. So when you're comparing keto, Atkins, and paleo, there's really no comparison. And people think that the keto diet is just rewrapping the Atkins diet, that the Atkins diet was super popular 20, 30 years ago, and all we're doing is repackaging it. No, the Atkins diet wasn't focusing on ketones. The ketogenic diet is focusing on science, and that's exactly what I'm focusing on here. And we've had so many success stories when it comes down to the ketogenic diet. People lose a lot of weight with the ketogenic diet, and they keep it off, because studies are starting to show that your resting metabolic rate doesn't decrease when you're on a ketogenic diet, meaning your metabolism still stays elevated even though you're reducing calories and reducing your weight. So this January, I challenge you to try my ketogenic diet plan and see how well that it works for you. And in tomorrow's video, I'm gonna share the science behind why becoming fat adapted is actually the key to fat loss, and how you can become fat adapted even without permanently following a ketogenic diet. But you're gonna wanna keep it locked in here at SixPackAbs.com all week long, because over the next few days, I'm gonna be releasing all new keto videos every single day, sharing you in on science behind the best and the worst keto workouts, keto-friendly veggies, and all the other stuff that you absolutely need in your keto diet. I'm also gonna share the downsides of keto and also my all-time best-tasting chocolate keto cake recipe. And that's not all. For this week only, I am opening my website for early enrollment into my KETOX program. So I'm gonna be drawing 100 lucky viewers from my early enrollment list to win the complete KETOX diet course absolutely free. Plus, when you enroll, you're also gonna get a free copy of my Pizza Lover's Keto Pizza Cookbook. So to enter for your chance to win, just go ahead and click on that link that's down in the description. And stay tuned in. I'll see you guys tomorrow.